We have had no-code tools for many years now. First, we had WordPress. Then we got tools like Wiz and Squarespace in the early 2010s, followed by tools like Shopify, Webflow, Framer, and Bubble, which captured the imagination of many out there. And in reality, are now users just like me with no coding skills to develop almost anything. AI took it to the next level. Tools like Replit Agents, Lovable, Bolt, V0, Cursor captured the imagination of many. And for good reason, this tool allows you to create almost anything just by typing prompts into an input field, and it comes out with realistically completed websites. But we haven't seen a good mix of both. And I think they both have their own merits. That's why today's tool that we're showcasing is great, because this tool allows you to have the flexibility of no-code tools with the power of AI coding tools. ReWeb combines some of the best features that you find in no-code tools with an AI tool. As an example, here we have a dashboard that I started building a few days ago. So if I go back and I want to change the background, I don't have to go and prompt the AI to make those changes for me. I can actually make those changes myself and start working on exactly what I need in order to be able to accomplish what I want without having to spend a whole lot of time doing a whole bunch of changes with AI, which in reality consumes a lot of time and money, because you have to pay for every prompt or every time that you prompt the AI. So these changes are done automatically. I'm going to reset this to my old colors. Another thing is that I can just cut elements and I can paste them in other places that I want to place them to without having to prompt the AI to actually go and do this automatically with the AI. I can actually go and make changes myself, or I can ask the AI to make them for me. As an example, if I want this to be service customer, I can actually do that manually, which is the magic of the no-code tools meets with the AI that you have available here in ReWeb. Now, moving on, and before we get to the AI portion, a few other things that I want to highlight are that you can change all your fonts here from this sidebar. You can change every single color that you have predetermined in your color palette for your application. Also change the radius here, go up and down. It's up to you what you want, but you have quite a few options here that allow you to generate as much as you can manually rather than with the AI saving credits. Now, you have some controls down here, so you can use the pen, so you can move things around your canvas. And this is really similar to how Figma works. So if you have used Figma in the past, you're going to be really familiar with how ReWeb works. So undo and redo, you can zoom out and zoom in, all these controls that you had grown accustomed to as you have been using Figma in the past. You can also see how they look on mobile, tablet, or desktop. You can also open these on a brand new tab, which allows you to see it how users are going to see it. Let's go back here. And you can create related components. So basically different versions for the same component. You can create variants, again, similar concept. You can copy this into Figma so you can continue editing Figma. And later on, we're going to be talking about how you can bring your designs Figma to ReWeb, which make it perfect, because if you need to take stuff from ReWeb to Figma, you can, and then you can bring it back to ReWeb to continue doing your editing. And lastly, you can view the code. All the code is available for you to see and to be able to copy it and take it to your favorite hosting provider. Just close this. Let's open back the dashboard. All right. And that's pretty much it here. So you can reload, duplicate, rename, so on and so forth. I don't think we need to spend too much time on that. Here you have your element tree where you can see exactly everything that is in there. And another way is you can just add more elements by duplicating. So we're going to delete that. I think we're good here. Now for the important part, you want to make sure that the AI can actually produce designs just like these ones that you're seeing. Because reality is that you don't know how much time I actually spend putting this together. So let me show you how easy it can be. So I'm going to create a related component. And for this related component, what I'm going to do is we're going to create a revenue screen, which will be the screen that will be linked to this revenue button. Because as you can see, we already have the invoices screen and the task screen, but we don't have a revenue one. What we're going to do is we're going to ask the AI to create it for us. And as you can see, it's working on that. It's using the same general layout, so it's not losing context of how the layout is actually built or the colors that it uses or how the logo look like or exactly where each element should be based on the general pattern that it has generated for the last few other screens. So we're going to allow it a moment to be able to put this together and let's see how it goes. All right, as you can see, it's almost done. It's actually creating the last few widgets. It's glitching, but that is because the AI is still working. And once it's done, you're going to be able to see it just like this one. And look like we're done. Yep, it's done. So as you can see, now it's not glitching anymore. You actually have a really polished design based on the aesthetics, colors, the design patterns from all the other screens that we have already created. So from here, what we could do is we could just go here to, let's see, to invoices, and we can create a related component. Let's see, create a crow page, which, let's use Whisper actually. We'll show, Whisper is not activated, sorry. We'll show, company as well as other. That. I wish they would have added a voice, a way for us to provide voice commands or to use our voice to generate the prompt. It's what it is. It's a small deal. But basically from here, we can create as many screens as we need. And like I said before, you can take all this information back to Figma, polish it a little bit more, make changes, add elements, which at the moment it doesn't seem to be available here on ReWeb, but it should be available in the future. At least that's what I believe. That's the direction they're going. A good mix in between no-code tools and AI coding tools. So we will see. So you can see right here is already generating all the growth analytics. I didn't provide it much context because I don't want to make this video super extra long for no reason. I want to make sure that you actually have the context that you need. And as you can see, it's almost done. Let's give a moment. And I'm not editing this part. This part, you get to see exactly what it is and how it looks like. So there is no hiding behind anything. What you're seeing is what is creating. I'm not making any changes, my buddy. So it looked like it's done generating. And yes, it doesn't have the shards right here, which that's the reason why you can take it back to Figma, because on these elements, it didn't have the context to add the shards. Or what you can do is you can copy this shard, paste it in here. Then we can delete this. And now we have our revenue growth there. Again, and delete this one and this one. Paste another shard there. Then you can make edits with AI. So I can click on the shard and I can ask AI to make changes and make sure that the shard actually reflects the data that I need to reflect rather than the data that the AI thinks. Now let's talk about pricing. ReWeb is priced similar to most other AI coding tools. And while ReWeb is a front-end coding tool, which means that you cannot generate the back-end or connect to Supabase or build workflows with it, you can generate relatively beautiful designs with a tool that is relatively similar to Figma. And you can even export your designs to Figma to further polish. But with that being said, they do have a free plan which comes with 10 credits per month. And you can export your code and host it in any tool out there. You can also use your code as a starting point for most AI coding tools like Bolt, Lovable, V0, Replic Agents. And by the way, the code export as React Native. So you can realistically use your code with most AI coding tools. But other than their free plan, you can go to their pro plan, which costs $20 per month and comes with 150 credits per month. I only use about 5-6 credits for this video, which was relatively low compared to most other AI coding tools. And I can say based on personal experience that is relatively cheap when you take into consideration how this tool works for you. And you can also go to their team plan, which costs only $30 per month. It's a $10 difference and you get 50 additional AI credits. You can also, if you run out of credits, you can purchase credits on your own and that make it relatively simpler rather than having to jump to a higher plan. But in my opinion, this is a relatively inexpensive tool for what it does, and you can connect it to Figma and go back and forth. With this being said, we have reached the end of this video. I want to say thank you for watching until the end. This being a really amazing opportunity for me to share with you about a great tool that I just found out about. And while we have recorded a video about 6 months ago, this tool has changed quite a lot in the last 6 months and it's completely redesigned. I consider it as fine because what it used to be and what it is now, there is a big difference. With that being said, thank you for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. I will leave you a link down in the description below for a few videos that you should be watching if you're interested in getting started to the AI coding movement. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you in the next video.